Yeah, so Mad War Games here. Let's check out Crash Dive 2, The Silent Service, a game about World War II Pacific submarines. And yeah, it's not a sim, it seems to be more action game. You can get it on Steam. And yeah, I'm more into sims, but I wanted to check it out. Well, the reviews are not too bad, and sure. Yeah, and this shooter game, I will check it out afterwards. I first need to download it. This is a bit bigger. Did you ever do a Silent Hunter 3 4 playthrough? Yes, but not that it was before I started the channel. Silent Hunter 3 is pretty good with mods. Yeah, I know. I played all Silent Hunter with mods. I played the heck out of Silent Hunter 3 with mods. I played the heck out of Silent Hunter 4 with mods, and also played Silent Hunter 5. Which I consider modded to be the, to this date, best what Modders ever achieved in Silent Hunter, despite the game being a train wreck on release. But yeah, all three games are beautiful modded. All three Silent Hunters. Silent Hunter 4 is also good. Modding seemed to be to me to be a bit easier. Now, did you mod as well on your own? Or you mean installing mods? Okay, they have a timer climb. Not too bad. Didn't expect this from an action game. You can bottom. That was also nice. Okay. Yeah, okay, it is training ships, yeah. I guess in the remissions it will be looking different. That is basically fake ships. Installing them. Cylinder 4 seemed to have more megapacks that made installing a snap. Where Cylinder 3 subcommander and lots of little add-ons is a pain. Yeah, I know what you mean. But I think at least for Cylinder 4 and 5 there is currently they made it easier. It depends of course on what mod you want to play. But at least when it comes to Operation Monsoon or this rising of the I forgot the fall of the Rising Sun or whatever it was called, that is basically one of the major mods for Silent Hunter 4. And Silent Hunter 3, yeah, is GWX still a thing, but I think it was succeeded by something else, right? I mean, I made a video on the 1 year ago on the best newest mod setup. But it's already quite some time since I played Silent Hunter 3. But it is I spent a ton of with it. Silent Hunter 3 was really my first real subsim. And absolutely next level. Especially thanks to modders. I mean the main game is also great. And I think Silent Hunter 5 is probably from zero to hero like no other game. The main game is a train wreck. And the modded game with Steel, Wolves of Steel, whatever, is probably one of the best submarine sims ever created. The biggest detail, even an entire working Enigma machine. Impressive, yeah. Modders are really impressive. That's also why I have little respect for developers that try to basically to get modders out of their game. Because 99.9% they're profiting even for free from their work. Okay, yeah, well, of course, very important, yeah, I always play the tutorials, I want to skip it a bit up, but, yeah, it's a lot of useful information. I don't know, still have GWX, but I modded the heck out of it with little add-ons. Silent Hunter 5, Vanilla was mine, yeah, nobody plays Vanilla, get Wolves of the Steel. That mod is simply nuts. Yeah, that is. I mean, there's a lot of realism features you don't need to use. Yeah, like manual navigation by stars or Enigma machine, that might be great for a couple of times, but then it might become very time consuming if you need to decipher whatever. They did a good mix, yeah, those unimportant messages you don't need to decipher with the Enigma machine, but those basically those main messages you need. It would be really too hardcore if you need to decipher every weather report with the Enigma. That would be too nuts. And I think I never played with manual navigation, that is also making it even crazier. Probably most realistic World War II submarining possible. Where you don't know where you are. You have no map information, but you need to basically figure yourself out where you are and then mark it on the map. But you can also play it with less of those super hardcore features. But still crazy, very good. But yeah, it's a matter of taste. So when I made those videos about Silent Hunter, there's usually those fanboys that come over. Yeah, Silent Hunter is the best. 3 is the best. Silent Hunter 5 is the best. Usually people that love Silent Hunter 3, they either never played modded Silent Hunter 5, and doesn't matter. Yeah, play what you like. And both have a great history. I played the hacker. And for Pacific Boats, of course, especially Silent Hunter 4 ISO modded, a really great thing. I remember playing this FOTLS U-mod, and it really gave me this very lethal experience at the beginning, where you are having basically the Japanese have the superiority. Oh, is that a 30 calibre? Okay. So all three sims modded still to this very day. Pole position. What the heck is this? Yeah, okay, thanks. Magnetic detection array, okay. Yeah, there were a lot of losses in the Pacific, two mines. I guess a lot of subs were lost because Japanese ASW was Not, I was dangerous, and of course, nothing to taken too lightly, but it was not on par with Allied ASW in the Atlantic. There was even a claim that they basically, for the first 2 years, detonated their depth charges on the wrong depth. But some boats were sunk by. But a lot of boats were lost to mines. Pacific submarines. Okay, ja. Gut. Full speed ahead. That's how you cross the minefield. Like in, what is the movie called here? Oh shit. Like in Hunter Killer. Yeah, most realistic sub movie, but it is too good. Sometimes you simply need some Gerard Butler action period. Oh. Well, Tony, it becomes quite dangerous here. Tony, are you sure? Look at this, that is really Hunter Killer style. Ah, okay. Yeah, that is exactly how they did that. While drinking coffee. That was business as usual. Hey, yeah, this double click can kill you. Wait, I can also do it. Ah, great. No. Easy. Yeah, interesting. Some of those management aspects are quite sophisticated, which I find good. Like here, damage control and crew management. Something you wouldn't expect from an arcade or from an action game. Even with what appears to be skills or experience. Okay, yeah. The rest we might manage out while. Okay. Yeah, there might be some important information I might miss now, but I want to play now. Check out what content is in the main game. Yeah, it's an included manual. Come on, imagine, I don't know, not sure, but could imagine this game is also on tablets or something, because it seems to be having being ready for touch controls. So there is a custom game, which is basically a mission editor or quick mission editor. Then we have a single convoy, which I guess randomly generates a convoy attack. A war patrol is basically you leaving the base, and when you come back, it is done. But I guess most people are interested in seeing the... I will deactivate the music for this video. Most people are interested in the campaign. What was the fourth difficulty? Right. Sim? Oh, okay. What is Sim? Yeah, so I guess let's play medium then. Sim is... Didn't even manage to get 5 meters out of the starting zone already being... Paint scheme, flat black. I want a black submarine. Ah, maximum zoom level. Sonar range. Soft. AliExpress. Good. So there must be a... I wonder, is there a outside view? I guess not. That's now black. Okay. Bomber, okay. So you're sending a submarine after a bomber. Okay, let's go. Whatever you say. What are we supposed to do? Attack it with a... with a deck gun or anti-aircraft. Okay. Cruise missiles. U-Sets, yeah. Torpedo in the water. The guy, I hope the destroyer escort game turns out to be pretty good. I think the destroyer side of submarine warfare is such an unrepresented thing in warfare game. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, U-Boat, this destroyer, the U-Boat Hunter, exactly. It looks pretty good. Definitely needs some work. Yeah, there's nothing. I mean, we had, of course, destroyer command. This. Company game here, this sidekick of Silent Hunter 2. It was not too bad. Modders also improved it. Yeah, I hope that this new game... it looks pretty good, at least from a presentation side. I mean, there's not much content currently there to show, so I have no idea how they will work out the campaign. Physics also seem to be a bit wonky. But nevertheless, yeah, best hope that this will be something really good. And yeah, that perhaps WDS might take another look at Wolfpack and improve the ASW AI mechanics in this game. And yeah. Yeah, slow down the time tune. Okay. Let me check. Wow, Tony, those guys are really close. Okay, looks like a nice target. Sub chaser. Small Corvette class or something. Not really worth. Where are the other ships? Wasn't there some huge ship in front of me? Where is it? What is that? Cargo ship. Okay, that's the guy I want. Oh yeah, end of war is done. After 10 years. Okay. Good, let's intercept this, our target. There's a sub chaser guarding him, we will ignore him, but perhaps we will send a torpedo. After I fire two torpedoes, but I don't want to tip off the cargo ship, that is our primary target. This sub chaser is not important for me. I want the cargo ship. Lower the periscope in order not to get detected. Yeah, Steam and Iron, we need to play that again. Very good game. I think I have the Turkish campaign open. I think those guys basically built with Rule the Waves and with Steam and Iron, they built the best campaigns ever made in naval surface simulations. Yeah, that's a nice feature here. You don't know where they are, but this game will further extrapolate with your current information where they might be. That is great. Yeah, we need to watch out for the sub chaser. He will be exactly in our way. But we already had a nice distance from my fire. Let's see, we need for the sub chaser, we might need. I mean, we can already turn a bit. We need somewhat like 2 minutes and 2:30 for this guy. So, some sort of. Yeah, not really true, wait. Yeah, no, that's fine. Depends. Something like 30-45 seconds difference between both targets. And I might fire from lead in order to make sure that this guy doesn't detect the torpedoes and then cause alert before they reach our target. Okay, let's position the boat, slow down. Get the periscope out. And he didn't notice the torpedoes. It should work out exactly like planned. The torpedo might miss. Second is looking good. Ah, but if we have really bad luck here. Okay, torpedoes are detected. Oh, come on, are you kidding me? Yeah, but he might turn and... Oh, no. Yeah. Okay. Okay, at least he got him with the tip. But the subchaser is incoming. We might need to get out of here. I mean, we could... Well, wait, let's see. We can fire one torpedo right into him. But he's currently circling. By accident. He's getting close. Get away from here. Oh, they even called in an aircraft. Yeah, that was a bit too cocky here to try to attack the subchaser. Especially the subchaser is absolutely worthless target. Uh oh. So you should rather play it somewhat in a realistic fashion, despite its mechanics. Not go toe-on-toe with escorts. This guy has a pretty good lead here. I like the sounds, yeah. The sound design is some nice sounds there. Like in our direction. No, I think that is pretty good made. Well made, that is not. From the screenshots, it looked a bit like you shoot at everything, but it seems like it incorporates more realism than I was expecting. Or real tactics, or whatever you want to call it. Okay, seems like we escaped. And not sure what is going on with the surface ship. Was it reported destroyed? But it was definitely not looking good. We might stay in this area when they continue or whatever. We might come back and kill it. But I think this red X indicates that it is a goner, right? No, that is the last location. Yeah, we will now wait. Speed up the game. Seems like guys going back at home. And we might check out the area. Now they are still here. Looking like crazy for me. Go home. Want to see where is the ship. But perhaps it was already sunk. I mean, can I, is there somewhere I can check? Let's see. Can't tell. Doesn't seem like. You know, protecting the ship? You know, it's slowed down. He's protecting it, okay. What? What's going on here? Are those guys moving? Hey, Jimmy, don't ask twice. Fire. Seems like this convoy for some reason is not moving. Tony, I won't ask why. I will do my job. But could be that this is the ship which we hit. This guy seems to be moving, yes. But he's snaking. Chances are very low that we will hit him. That is also the subchaser. That is a cargo ship. This torpedo seems to be not really on course. Ah, it is. Okay, go down. He will come at us. Should finish the ship. Okay, a cargo ship spotted our torpedo, might be inbound. And ship sunk. That is a message from sky. Son, I have a holy mission for you. Good, let's get out of here before the subchaser finds us. Yeah, that is, I'm rather positively surprised by this game. I was really expecting you deck gunning yourself. I mean, some of those missions have interesting objectives like locate some bomber or whatever. But when it comes to the convoy hunting and how it plays out, it is well made. Oh, he is coming, okay. Wait, that is... this Jimmy really has... absolutely a good... a good sense. Sixth sense here. It's coming straight at us. Straight out of Compton. It's the subchaser, yeah. By accident, or does this guy, for whatever reason, know where we are? You are just passing by random. I absolutely have no idea that you're here. Everybody needs to know to catch its sweat. What does this indicate? He knows that we are here. If he now fires the Aztec, the sonar, the active sonar, he might think, what is this big thing here on my, this big spike? Might be Free Willy, or might be a US submarine. But Jimmy, didn't you find a better place to circle your boat? But, I mean, we are below the layer, he shouldn't hear us. It's slowly away. Hey, what? Did he find me? I think he found me. doesn't look like. I mean, it seems like the game is informing you when you are found. But I like it that they think they found something. Yeah, that is great. That is nice features. They think they found something there, and now death charging the heck out of this. But they didn't. That is nice. We well made. I have no time for radio. Okay, you've made it. Yeah, nice game. Definitely nice. Yeah, what you call it? Simcade. It is not really an arcade action game. I wouldn't call it arcade. It is not Silent Hunter. It's something in between. Yeah, Simcade. Action sim or whatever you want to call it. Yeah, check it out, it is on Steam, not that expensive. And seems to be well made. Not some cheap game. And you see this can be quite dramatic. Watch out with the difficulty sim, it is one of those games. I mean, there's other games that also use terms like sim or realistic, where this term might translate to very brutal difficulty. Okay, yeah. Now we will check out the shooter. It is done downloading. See you.